Welcome back, folks. So the idea for this video came out of the feedback I received for a previous video I made on how to use Metasploit to pentest Modbus, which turned out to be one of the most viewed on this channel. This time we'll look into how to use Metasploit to retrieve admin passwords out of Moxa NPort. So the Moxa NPort series are industrial serial device servers that connect RS-232, 422, and 485 devices to Ethernet, and are designed to provide robust performance in demanding environments. Essentially, they convert serial data to TCP/IP format. Also, and this is going to be very important in our demonstration, they're often configured with an open telnet connection, which can be exploited. Moving on to Shodan, we can easily locate exposed devices with a simple dork, port 4800, Moxa and port in single quotes. And as you can see here, we find well over 4,000 devices. If you check out the status of these clients, you'll notice that most of it has it have it as an unknown, while others are labeled with either authentication enable or disable. Now we'll focus on the former category, so we add authentication enable to our query. And here we find roughly 650 NPort devices with authentication enabled. You also notice that most of these come with the ICS tag as well, so they're likely part of industrial complexes. Now, moving on to Metasploit, I'll be showing you a module that allows for the recovery of login credentials, as well as unauthorized access to configuration details, which very often include plain text usernames and passwords. Now, by leveraging this vulnerability, we can therefore retrieve admin credentials. We can search for Moxa and then use to, which is the module we need. Now, we can show options to see what arguments are required. As you can see, we have a function creds, which pulls credentials or enumerates the function codes, which are either creds or enum. We also need to specify your remote host IP address and the remote port, which defaults at 4800. Now, we can clear up the terminal we used to, which actually we've already done. Now we can specify a function with the set function creds. Next, we'll set the target port, which defaults at 4800, as we just said. And now we can specify the remote host, which I'm going to blur since this is a live target I'm testing as part of a recent penetration test we performed. So we set the remote host. Okay, done. And finally, we can run the module. And as you can see here, we have successfully retrieved the password, and we also have information about the SNMP community, which is public. Now, as I mentioned before, Moxa and NPort are very often configured with an open telnet connection, which we can exploit to gain remote access. So we do telnet and the remote host IP address. Right. Now we supply the password for Cali. There you go. We have a connection. So next, it prompts us for authentication. So we need to supply the password we just found. And just like that, as you can see, we are in. Now, from this main menu, we have a bunch of options available. We can check out the network settings first. So we can type 2. There you go. So here we have information about IP addresses, DNS servers, SNMP contact and location. We can type N and go back. And now we select 4 to check out the operating system. Now, one of the most dangerous aspects of this particular exploit is the possibility to change the admin password, since we are already logged in as administrator. So by selecting 9, which is the change password option, we can supply the old password. And then we can set another one of our choosing. So we key in our selection 9, we input the old password. Now we type a new password. We do it once again. Now, as you can see, the set password has been successful. Now we can go back and we need to save our changes. We press yes and we're done. So once again, I invite you all to use this information wisely and keep in mind that these techniques are only to test systems where you have prior authorization. I hope you guys have enjoyed the video and I'll see you in the next.